April 26 is Power of Econ Day. Stay tuned at the end of this podcast to find out about the free, engaging financial literacy resources for Power of Econ Day, brought to you by Econ Essentials and Discovery Education. Bringing Literature to Life in Open Sim, Episode 293. The 10-Minute Teacher Podcast with Vicki Davis. Every weekday, you'll learn powerful, practical ways to be a more remarkable teacher today. Today, we're talking with Mary Howard, sixth grade teacher in New York State, and she was a finalist for New York State Teacher of the Year for this year, 2018. Mary, you are bringing literature to life in Open Sim. Now, you and I were actually talking before the show. I used to do some work in Open Sim, and people really pushed me towards Unity, and I found it to be really hard. What is Open Sim? And it sounds like there are people still using it, huh?
Yeah, there's still quite a few educators, especially out in the trenches, using OpenSim. And sometimes it's a hard concept to describe, but it's a virtual environment. And, you know, we hear a lot of talk now in EdTech circles about how we can get these students engaged and speak a language that they're speaking. And really, an OpenSim or an Open Simulator is a great way to do that. We bring these students in a virtual world. And they have an avatar, and that avatar walks around this virtual world. And then I incorporate my curriculum through the virtual environment. It's really exciting stuff.
Yeah. So educators, think about, you know, some people host their own Minecraft servers. And this is in some ways like Second Life. So it looks a little bit more realistic than the pixelated Minecraft types, and a lot of really cool things you can do in OpenSim. So what are you doing with Anne Frank and teaching literature in your OpenSim world, Mary?
The students have this world that they go into. The platform is held at a server with our local BOCES. And like you described, just to give people a little more of a background, it's really great for middle schoolers because a lot of the middle schoolers, by the time they've hit sixth and seventh grade, they've moved on beyond Minecraft, or they really can't get their heads around the fact that a teacher is necessarily using Minecraft. And so this, I always say to the students, it's like Minecraft on steroids. You know, we've gone away from the pixelation, yet we still have the power of the building and construction, which really speaks to, you know, students and creativity. So with the program that I use, the Anne Frank House was actually redesigned in the virtual environment for the students to visit. So they go into a reconstructed Anne Frank House. They read, of course, the novel, the companion novel that goes along with it, and they're able to sort of see and visualize what's going on in the novel. Yet they're also able to build and construct their own reflective pieces within the virtual environment. Or in one case, a student actually built a bomber, World War II bomber, and placed that in the Anne Frank Museum that's in the virtual world. So there's just so many ways to be more hands-on with a novel when you're using a virtual environment.
What are some of the things that students are really taking away that you couldn't get from just a class discussion about Anne Frank?
Well, it's really an engagement practice. The virtual environment group that I work with, this Open Sim group, I actually don't do the Anne Frank House. I do an extension off of that that came from that initial project. And it was a 3-year project. And so several teachers began the Anne Frank, and that's actually in our 7th and 8th grade curriculum in our building. But then I began the project in this Open Sim environment with an heir of the king. So you sort of have to imagine the Middle Ages and medieval times, which